The other day I saw the news, and we saw the parents, my father's colleagues being interviewed, and the wives were also, some of the wives of the fishermen were also interviewed, and some of them died. Yes, I understand all of that. It's very important. But now, what about us now, my generation, us, the middle ones now, the ones that were forced to go into adulthood at an early age, the ones that were forced to kill their dreams of going for studies and becoming someone. What about us now? Us that had to take all the punches that came with the stress and the psychological impact the parents got, our fathers got. What about us that had to wake up now early in the morning and go do double shifts, double work, just to bring in money to pay for the bills because our fathers could not bring in money anymore. I had friends. Because it was difficult, it was very difficult. I had friends that we finished school together, but they went on to become teachers. Some of them became accountants. And I also had my dreams to become an educator, but I could not do that because my father could not fund my education. To fill in a form, just an application form, is in the thousands, like $5,000 already. And I couldn't do that. I had to kill that dream because I had to be an adult now to take care of my father, my mother, my little brother in the house, pay our bills. Now, while I want to know, good, we found out about the fish rot nonsense, the bribery and everything. That's why our fathers were laid off. Now, what I want to know is, well, what will the government do with this money that's been recuperated now? The accounts have been frozen. Yes, we understand that. I watched the news also. My question is now, will the government do something about us that want to go study? Because we want to study. Will they give the money back to the rightful owners? What will happen with these fishermen, with us? Can we start being the youth that we want to be by going to study and becoming important pillars in the country also? I thank you.